Thank you. My prob opportunity I did was stress on high school teens, and I picked it because it's a problem that it's easily noticeable. People complain about it a lot, and it's just something that I figured I'd look into. And in relation to Jacob's project, I also tend to procrastinate. I just call it something different. Call it stress management, and it works pretty well. And that is not why I don't have a visual aid. I don't have a visual aid because I wanted to make it more of me talking to you instead of you reading what I have to say. And so in my research, I connected with a couple of my friends because I wanted to know how they deal with their stress on a day-to-day basis from their viewpoint. And then I went to a guidance counselor at our school, and I got what he thought was causing it. And I also used my information I learned in ACP psychology to better understand stress and understand what really causes it. And in connecting with students, most of them will blame it on homework and things like that, and just not having enough time to do what they want. And in connecting with the guidance counselor, he says that it's more of competition with other classmates than it is just not having time. Like, it's a lot of weight that's put on students here, and it's, can I do better than this person can? Can I get an A plus and be the best in this class? And Mr. Poyer says that that's a lot of what he thinks it could be. And I personally don't agree with that. I think that most people in here could really care less if they're the best in here. And I think that's a good thing in a way and a bad thing in a way, because you should always want to have competition, but when it starts putting too much pressure on you, you should always know when to realize that you kind of just got to go with the flow, and you don't have to be stressed about it. It's the way I modeled how I deal with my stress and all that stuff, and that's my solution, is to share with other people how I deal with stress and how they don't have to really worry about it as much and be as wound up about it, I guess. I'm not the best at talking to people. I tend to tell them to suck it up, but that's okay, because what they gotta do.
Competition that causes stress. You believe there is stress. Where is it coming from?
I think it's kind of a combination of both. I think it's a combination of having a lot to do and competition. But it all depends on the individual, kind of. So, like, if one person is the best in the class and they sit next to a kid who does absolutely terrible, that kid probably sits there and tells himself, I don't care what I get, but the kid sitting next to him that gets good grades, he wants to be there. For him, it's competition. For other people, it's not having enough time. So if you're in a good position, you're going to want to remain in a good position.
So the one that's not doing as well will think he has too much homework? Is that what you're saying?
So the kid that's stressed out about too much homework is typically the kid that doesn't do their homework. Does that make sense?
Procrastination.
Yes. Procrastination, like Jacob's project.
Stress relief.
Yeah. Stress relief. Don't worry about it. And then the kid that's stressed out about competition is the one that's wanting to do good because they're already doing good. They just want to remain there.
I would say a lot of that is subjective, depending on which person it is, because When I was in high school, I didn't particularly love school. I didn't really, you know, base my value off my grades. I wasn't in the top 10%, but I graduated with honors. But I didn't necessarily want to be there, you know, and I didn't have the best grades in the class, but I still made sure that I did my work, not because I wanted to, but because I have to.
Yeah.
So I don't think it's necessarily that the people that do good or do well have always been doing well, mm-hmm. and the people that are doing poorly have always been doing that, so they're sticking with that. I think a lot of it depends on the person. And I always found when I was in high school, there are so many students that are incredibly stressed out about school, and it's not just the ones who feel like they have too much homework or not enough time, but a lot of it is the people that are putting so much of their, you know, their identity into their grades. I've seen a lot of people where, you know, they're, you know, having panic attacks, you know, regularly because of the weight of school. And I think a lot of it for me, when if I would start to get stressed out in your tears about studying for a test, I would say, okay, my mental health is more important than, you know, the difference between A and C on A and C on this one test. So, but another point of clarification, you said you want to share with people how you deal with stress. Mm-hmm. I didn't catch, how did you say that you generally deal with it?
I don't typically get stressed out as much as normal people would, I guess, because I just kind of go with the flow and live it day by day. I view it as if I'm still breathing, I can always better my situation and better where I'm at in school and financial reasons for things like that. You can always better yourself if you're still there to do it.
Right. So how do you feel that you, as someone who doesn't stress out, could advocate and teach people about how not to be stressed?
That's kind of what I got to work on. Because, like I said, I tend to tell people to suck it up, and I'm not very good at teaching people things, because I'm just not a good teaching mm-hmm. person, so I have to work on that, and be able to learn how to talk to people a little bit better, and not offend them, I guess.
Right, so I think if you want to find your solution, it'd be less of you teaching people how not to be stressed and to cope with it, less maybe finding someone who could actually, you know, was really stressed, since this seems like you might not be the best advocate for that.
Well, and also finding viable tools for stress relief, because you can tell someone don't stress. That doesn't work unless they're given a tool that allows them, maybe it's the procrastination app, that allows them to refocus their stress energy on something that moves them in a positive direction. So it's not necessarily even empathizing with someone who's stressing as researching tools that can help them refocus that stress energy.
And that would also vary case to case, because it depends on what is stressing them out. So I think maybe I could help them in a way of, instead of just trying to talk to them about it, I could help them figure out what they need to do to better why they're stressed out. So like you said, people who procrastinate, the app would be good. Maybe I can help them figure out that that's a good way to fix their stress that they're having.
So now, why did you choose stress as your topic? If you feel that you don't get stressed out, you just say, go with the flow, and you're not a good teacher to be able to help people.
Because it bothers me. Like, it bothers me when people will sit there and be stressed out about something and freak out about it. And that makes me sound bad, but...
You know, that was like kind of the assignment at the beginning of the year when she said, what lights you on fire?
Yeah.
Okay.
I will say that sometimes it's the freaking out that relieves the stress. My high school career, I never wrote a paper until the last moment and after a crying gag, and then I get an A on it. So that was my coping mechanism. So there, it can be different
ones.
Things.
You can always find a better one.
The procrastination app would have been great.
Yep.
We didn't have cell phones then, so.
Come on, Jacob, you got to hurry up. Is there anything to, you know, another large creator of stress is relationships, and not necessarily just boyfriend, girlfriends,
you know, the relationships you have with other peers, you know, whether that's being bullied or
yeah.
or whatever it is, I think that would be just as large.
Yeah, I think
if not more large.
I think people focus too much on that, honestly, because, like, you're always going to have relationships. You can always make new ones. You can always fix them. So when people are really stressed out about them, it's...
Would you say that to somebody that tried to kill themselves, though?
No, I would not. But I...
Because it's a big deal to them.
Yeah, I know. I'm not saying that. I'm saying... there's always a way you can better relationships and better situations that you're in. And I think that I just need to help people realize that they can better what the situation that they're in, that's stressed out about relationships or stressed out about school.
Yeah, when you came in here to give this, I'm sure you had some measure in your mind of this is what it's going to take to have a successful. What was it?
Just a problem to me in a way that I can help someone else. Help someone else, help a community better themselves, kind of.
Okay,
and so I figured that stress in high school teens is something that I notice every day, and I felt like I could maybe help to fix that.
So, as far as the target market, you're looking at what? Is it a specific subset of a high school student? Is it the entire high school population?
The entire high school population, because everyone's stressed about something. I do stress out a little. I'm not saying, like, I'm perfect or anything. I do stress out a little bit. It's just, there's some people that stress out more, some people stress out less, but everyone gets stressed out. And I figure I don't understand why. We can always kind of better that.
Yeah, my point is, you're awfully broad.
Yeah.
And your solution, very broad. You've got a lot of work to do as far as what does that look like in your mind? If you are passionate about this, which I commend you, but what are you going to do about it? Who are you going to help? And more focused you get, the better it is to find a solution going forward. Right now?
Okay.
One of the things I heard you say was, I don't think everyone in here wants to necessarily be the best.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, this is America, and we all need to be the best at everything.
That's true. That's very true.
No, I'm just kidding. That's a joke. I thought we're being a little overly critical as sharks, and I'm just speaking as one shark, as to you not having anything to offer in terms of you not being stressed. I think you probably do, but I think what you are lacking, and some other sharks have said this, is maybe to interviewing some people who are stressed and sort of be like, so this is sort of the mindset that they're having that's causing them to be stressed. I've also heard you talk about, like, there's environmental stresses, like school and competition, but I didn't hear a whole lot about it being in their mind, so it's kind of, I see it as twofold. It's environmental, but it's also personal.
Yeah.
You can have a negative thought patterns going on in your mind, and you can be your own worst enemy.
Mm-hmm.
And so there's a psychological aspect to this that I didn't hear that much about.
If I touched more on that, I was more worried about getting attacked by sharks. So I've already been criticized for what I have said, and when I was touching on environmental stresses, and I do tend to tell people that you suck it up and move on, and if I touch more on personal stress and, like, just it being in their heads, kind of make me sound a little mean and rude,
I'll
just try not to go for that.
Well, if you look at how psychologists deal with people who have high anxiety, for example, like one thing they might do is something called CBT, cognitive behavioral therapy. So I would look into that and then not be afraid to talk about it, because if you talk about CBT, you're not going to come off as being a jerk. and it's a professional therapy.
Okay. That's just something I didn't run across in my research, but I'll definitely look into it.
There's one thing I found in my work for the government, and when I was dealing with people who had trouble at work, looked like they were stressed out. That's when I was in high school. What you find out when you sit down and you get a chance to talk to the person, this kind of dovetails with what Darlene said, you find out there is another reason the person is stressed out. Sometimes what you think they're being stressed out about isn't really what the thing is. Maybe there's something going on at home. Maybe they've got a relative who's got some problems. So if you really want to help, and I think you really do, I mean, this bothers you that you see people being stressed and you're not as stressed, but you want to help them. The real way to do that, in my experience, is something you might want to think about doing solution-wise, is just sit down and talk to people that you know who you feel are stressed. Just get them to talk.
Yep.
And it's amazing what you will find. You'll find out, okay, I thought this is the reason. Boom, there's another reason once I hear them talk. But I finally understand what the real problem is. And leave yourself kind of open for that would be my suggestion.
Okay.
But no, it's just clear you really do care about this. And you don't feel like it's, I mean, a big problem.
Yeah.
How can I help you with that big problem?
So, yeah, it's not a, it might not be a big problem for me, but it's a big problem for other people.
Sure.
And
so
I like
about,
to help other people. So that's
so think, try to think a little more about this. It kind of dovetails with what you said.
Yeah.
Get underneath the hood a little bit, surprisingly.
Okay.
And I do want to say that not all stress is bad. I think, especially in high school, you need to have some stress. You need to realize that, you know, life is not going to be easy. Do a worksheet, turn it in, I'm done. I mean, some stress is good. It's how you handle it. And also competition as well. I just had this conversation with my son the other day about he is not competitive in the least. When I was questioning his third quarter grade, he said, well, the teacher put all the grades up there, and I was right here, and there were 15 kids who got worse grades than I did. And I said, well, why don't you compare yourself to the 15 kids who got better grades than you? So I think a little stress, instead of the ones that did worse, a little stress and a little competition is actually good for you because, I mean, that's what the workforce is.
Stress can be a motivator.
Yes, and if you live a stress-free life, you've never taken any risks and never had any failure come your way, which is what makes people what they are. Not
well,
to say that you need to get stressed out and have an episode or...
I do get stressed out. It's just not so much towards school and towards workloads or anything like that. I get stressed out about my car.
Well, and your take on relationships is not a 17-year-old boy, typical 17-year-old boy take on relationships. That's like 40, 50-year-old person. So you're definitely an anomaly in that respect. I wish other people did, especially people who are contemplating hurting themselves because of a relationship. They could just fast forward 20 years in their life. They might not even remember this 20 years from now. But yeah, I think it's a great subject. With all the mental health issues coming to the forefront now and the stigma-free things, I do think you might walk a fine line, with telling people your emotions are for the weak.
Yeah, that's...
you need to be careful with that.
Yeah.
And to go off with that, I did not mean to sound like I was criticizing you earlier, if that came off that way. I'm just more, what if you took your solution as to... I see you're having a problem, let's direct you to someone who can help you, and whether that is to the room in the library where they go and do like the color, excuse me, had like the adult coloring books, or go to a counselor where they're like trained and know how to talk to someone who is stressed out and they are able to help you with more situations that is not just workload at school or work, right? They can also help you with family issues and things like that. So if you took your solution and made it more of a community or a group of students who are trying to be kind of like liaisons, to point them and say, like, this is where you could find better help. Because you were saying, like, you don't know how to teach people how to get over it, and you say, build a bridge, get over it, or go with the flow. So it's like, some people, like, I have severe anxiety, I stress myself out.
Mm-hmm.
Having people tell me go with the flow drives me nuts because I don't know how to. So someone who is trained can say, okay, this is how you can go with the flow.
Yeah.
So it's just an idea to think about. So, sorry to keep off reading.
That's good.
Mm-hmm.
Any last thoughts for Gavin?
I just want to say good job. I'm kind of there with you, go with the flow type attitude.
Yeah.
I think what helps me, I mean, you're obviously going to always be stressed out about something. You know, it doesn't get any easier when you graduate. Go with the flow, what helps me is just say, hey, is this going to matter 5 minutes from now, 5 days from now, 5 weeks from now? If it's not, then why worry about it? Don't work yourself up. So, I don't know, that is something. And yes, I am a procrastinator as well.
Yeah. Stress management. Yeah. Sounds better.
All right, thank you, Gavin.